Noon, you're watching Israeli News Live. As you can see in the background, we are seeing Grad rockets being fired. And generally, when we see this type of scene here, we're thinking of, well, Ukraine for the most part, but not tonight. In fact, tonight in Aleppo, the rebel fighting forces against President Bashar al-Assad have launched a barrage of Grad rockets towards President Assad's own training camps there inside of Israel. You know, the thing is, what we're looking at tonight, friends, is just there is all types of unrest all over the world. And even RT reporting here today, the Russian foreign minister speaks of what's going on with the U.S. and North Korea. And he expresses tremendous concerns about how the outcome of North Korea could end up affecting the rest of the region, not just North Korea, and that how that so many people would end up dying as a result of this. And so he goes on and he's, you know, clearly makes it known that Russia is not just going to stand by idly as a war with North Korea were to be waged on. So, but how much Russia will get involved or not still remains to be seen. But, and that may have more to do with what is going on around the borders of Russia on the western side of Russia, eastern part of Europe here. This is on Lorenzo's site already happening. He says, we can see Russia increasing military movement around the country. One reason could be the latest NATO activities in the South Caucasus. In particular, about $75 million deal on deliveries of cutting-edge anti-tank missile systems, Javelin, to the Tbilisi is being recorded already from NATO. And also we know that NATO is doing this with Ukraine. They're sending in anti-tank weapons, arming the Ukrainian government, Petro Poroshenko. And then we have, to top all that off, we have, as two U.S. generals have warned, we're at the precipice of an enormous war. We're reminded one mistake could lead to calamity. This was here on the All News Pipeline, the article here that we were speaking about right here, though. This goes to the general that met there up with the Marines in Norway that stated that. We have also, according to James, Mad Dog Mattis has shared in this news story from Associated Press, storm clouds are gathering over the Korean Peninsula, warning the U.S. soldiers must do their part by being ready at any moment of war. Mattis' comments came soon after the U.N. Secretary Council voted unanimously to approve tough new sanctions against Kim Jong-un and his hermit kingdom over their continued belligerent threats of violence and ICBM test. So with that, and the general that also spoke of the saying that he hopes that he's wrong, but he expects that we're about to go into a major war. And then we see again, this one here on Live UMAP coming out, photo of Neklenoboka railway station in Rostov region receiving a bunch of Russian-made tanks. Now, that happens to be just only 30 kilometers from the border of Ukraine and Russia. And I did a little looking on the map there, and I thought I had the map here, so maybe we can actually just click over to the map. Yes, here we can. And we can see that train station here in behind us here. But if you follow where that train, that railroad route goes, it literally crosses right into Ukraine. So regardless of where this equipment is coming from, it goes into Ukraine there. And that railway system makes its way right up to Donetsk, to the east side of Donetsk right there. So, and this is where a lot of the fighting is going on. So it could be that Russia is stockpiling tanks, whether it's to protect their own border or whether to actually to send them into combat against the U.S. backing of Western Ukraine. I don't know the answer to this, but one thing's for sure, things are just really ramping up. And I think it's time to take inventory. By the way, fixing to go into another article here in just a few moments here. I'll be loading another newscast, possibly here on Israeli News Live as well. It will be airing on DeNoon Institute first. We're going to be looking at the Gog of Magog and how this is all ramping up, especially with the latest situation. Iranian MPs backed bill recognizing Jerusalem as Palestinian capital. That kind of lets me know they're not as in tune with the Vatican as some of the other Arab states there. They didn't say East Jerusalem, just Jerusalem. I'm Stephen Ben-Nun with Israeli News Live. Shalom and Erev Tov.